Do you want to experience maximum success when it comes to trout trolling? If you do, integrate trolling flies into your arsenal. Go on over to fishhuntshoot.com and pick up one of Kel Kellogg's Signature Series trolling fly kits today, and you'll be yelling fish on tomorrow. Howdy guys, Kel Kellogg here. It is time for the Northern California Foothills Trout and Landlocked Salmon Fishing Report. And I guess the big headline is spring has sprung. We're a few days into spring. We may see some more snow. We may see some more rain, but we're getting those big north winds. And that is a great indication that winter is giving way to spring. And those winds are kind of a double-edged sword. On one hand, it's a clear indication that we're moving into a spring pattern, but those winds can also keep you off the water. And you got to take a look at the wind forecast, especially if you're going to some of our bigger lakes or the Delta places like Folsom, of course, the Delta, the Sacramento River, Lake Berryessa. Those north winds can not only be strong, they can be dangerous. So take a second, check the wind forecast before you're hitting your favorite lake. I wouldn't blow off a fishing day because of the wind, but if I was going to a place like Berryessa, you know, I might move the target a little bit and go to a smaller body of water that offers more protection. So enough said about that. I'm excited about spring. You're excited about spring. And we have got some great bites underway. Let's start with Lake Pardee. Trollers at Pardee, they're doing very well. They're getting mixed limits of rainbow trout and kokanee salmon. The kokanee are running all the way up to about 12 and a half inches. Decent sized fish, not huge, not tiny, but decent sized fish that, you know, they make for some great fillets in the smoker. If you want to get the kokanee, pink or orange tubes or hoochies are working well behind 4-inch blades. Tip them with corn. Anise flavored corn, garlic flavored corn, and shrimp flavored corn are all working well. So basically all the common flavors of corn are working well out there. It's 0 to 20 feet both in the narrows and in the main lake. And guys that are targeting kokanee are catching, you know, plenty of rainbow trout on the kokanee gear. If you want to target the trout exclusively, you know, start out with the spoons, 2.2 miles an hour, cripple lures, trigger spoon juniors, needlefish, cast masters, all the standard stuff in both chrome patterns and orange patterns. They're both working well. Don't be afraid to pull that orange Rapala. That's producing rainbows. And if there's a brown around, you might pick up a brown as well. If you want to slow down, grubs are working well, threaded worms, standard trolling stuff. These are planted, you know, rainbows by and large. There's some holdovers in the lake, but mainly planted rainbows. Shore anglers, the standard stuff off the bank, guys. Power bait, power eggs, worms, cast masters, crappie jigs, it's all working. Watch the plants. You know, the water quality is great at Pardee. It's a really pretty setting. The turkeys are gobbling and all that kind of stuff in the spring. So if you're looking for a good old-fashioned fun fishing trip, whether you're trolling or you're fishing off the bank, Pardee's a very good bet. Right next door is Lake Comanche. Comanche is kicking out some robust trout. Limits and near limits, trollers, you know what they do at Comanche. Standard stuff, speed spoons, speedy shiners, some Rapala action mixed in. If they need to slow down, it's all about grubs and trolling flies. A lot of guys like to put a Berkeley power egg on their line in front of the grub if they're going to troll grubs. With the speedy stuff, anywhere from 2.5 to 3.5 miles an hour. If you're going to pull those grubs, keep it from 1 to about 1.8. Most of the time guys are pulling the grubs naked, but by all means, don't be afraid to team them with a dodger or, you know, a willow leaf dodger or a turbo flash or something like that. Kind of play with it. Surface to about 30 feet deep is getting it done out there, and you can expect to catch trout in a 14 to 16 inch range most of the time. There are a lot of 3 to 6 pounders being caught out there as well. Bank anglers continue to catch fish. Standard stuff, once again, power bait, power eggs, inflated worms, and if you hit the pond, it's all about power eggs or crappie jigs. But that's going well at Comanche for both trollers and bank anglers. If you're in the Stockton area, Sacramento area, you know, it's a short drive, get out there, get your fish on. There's always plenty of elbow room at Comanche. It's a large lake, so you can kind of get off and do your own thing. If you're a troller, start off by the island and work from there. Don't be afraid to go up into the river arm, you know, go work the face of the dam, whatever. So if you're a Comanche guy, you know what I'm talking about. If you've never visited Comanche, this is a great time of the year to get out there and get after them. them. It's a very pleasant setting. It's a great lake in the spring. It's not hot yet. Just make sure the wind, it can get windy there. So make sure what the wind's gonna do on the day that you plan your visit. Another lake right next door is Lake Amador. Amador continues to kick out, you know, limits and near limits, but that's not what I want to talk about. I want to talk about a ginormous trout that weighed 19.96 pounds. It was a rainbow, a new lake record. And the fellow's name, I have it written down here. The fellow that caught it, his name is Richard Vartoni, and he was top lining a gold and black floating Rapala near the mouth of Jackson Creek when that monster fish hit, and he landed it on 4-pound test line. So I'm sure he had quite a tussle on his hands. It is an incredible fish. Just a, I mean, it's as big as an ocean salmon. What more can you say? The thing is huge. So if you want to get a big fish, I don't know anywhere right now, except maybe Pyramid Lake, that's kicking out, you know, trout that are approaching 20 pounds. And they've caught several fish in that kind of size class out there in the last, say, 8 weeks or so. So if you want to go big, get on over to Amador. Access is great. Great facilities. It's a great place to visit. Bank anglers out there, they're using power eggs, power bait. I sound like a broken record. Trollers out there, golden black Rapalas are obviously a great bet. Rapalas are always a good bet for trollers at Amador. Woolly boogers are working well. My turbo boogers are catching fish. Castmasters, needlefish, that kind of stuff's catching fish. It's kind of random. And of course, grubs. You never want to visit Amador without some grubs and some power eggs, because teaming the power egg with the grub, just like they do at Comanche, can be absolutely deadly if the bite's a little bit slower. So that's kind of the story at Amador. Massive fish. One last congratulations to Richard, man. That is the trout of a lifetime. I don't care where you're fishing or what you're doing. Let's see here. We are going to wrap up with Folsom Lake. The King Bite, man, it continues to amaze out there. It's very good. It's not limits, but it's anywhere from 2 to 4 fish per rod up to about 24 inches. When they're in a mindset to chase, speed spoons and speedy shiners in copper. That's all you need to pull. You know, they're working anywhere from about 30 to 50 feet deep. Find a bait. They're getting them in the North Fork by that iconic outhouse cove. They're getting them out in the mid lake, and they're also getting them at the mouth of the South Fork. If you need to slow down, go with a 6-inch fisheye, a minnow tube, and tip that tube with a little piece of anchovy. Get your speed down into that probably 1.8 mile an hour range. Target the same depths. That rig will catch both trout and kings. I haven't heard about many of those big holdover or wild steelhead that some guys think they are out in Folsom. I think they're wild steelhead, but haven't heard about many of those being caught. It's primarily pan-size planters and the kings. Kings are very nice. You know, they're going from a pound and, like I said, at the upper end up to about 24 inches. A lot of 20 inchers, 18 inchers. Very nice fish, great eating. A great fight. The water's cold out there. The water skiers haven't shown up in MASH yet. So this is a great time to visit Folsom. And like I always say, we keep going back because one, there's some big fish in the lake and sometimes they bite. And two, it's close to most of our homes. So it's just an easy run over to Granite Bay, drop the boat and get after them. And remember, April, if you want to, you know, try your hand a little bit of bass fishing, you just want to go out and get in on some bass fishing fun, Folsom is a great place to go. All you need are a few 4-inch to 6-inch finesse worms. Blue colors work great. And my all-time favorite out there, a 4-inch brown or motor oil colored Senko wacky rig it. Look up how to wacky rig a Senko. Just go out there, start tossing that Senko in different areas off the points, near big boulders and stuff like that. And the bass, well, they'll take care of the rest. Because in April at Folsom, the spots, the largemouths, the smallmouths, they're all going to be up fairly shallow. They're getting ready to spawn, and they're pretty stupid that time of the year. So even trout fishermen like us can get out there and get our bass on. Anyway, that's all I got to say today. I know I'm rambling along pretty quickly here. I got a lot of stuff to get taken care of. I'm getting ready to hit Collins Lake for some guide trips. So I gotta get jumping here. You have a great day. Stay safe. And remember, if you're looking for trout gear, rods, reels, trigger spoons, flies, grubs, all that stuff and more, go on over to fishhuntshoot.com. landlocked.com and check out our selection of top-notch tackle, the same stuff you see me catching fish with right here on YouTube. I will catch you next time. You guys all stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, wear those life jackets. I'm Kel Kellogg, and I'm signing off.